about sunrise? What about rain? What about all the things that you said we were to gain? What about killing fields? Is there a time? What about all the things that you said was yours and mine? Did you ever stop to notice all the blood we've shed before? Did you ever stop to notice this crying earth, this weeping shore?
Encouraged by President Duterte's unprecedented order and instruction, where the PRA issued the cease and desist order on Coron's reclamation and the President's announcement on the immediate moratorium on all applications for reclamation throughout the country, Sagip Coron Palawan commenced and mobilized the rehabilitation of Coron's devastated coastal area with the launching of a coconut tree and mangrove planting on the illegally reclaimed lands last April 22, 2022. Starting at the St. Augustine Church, actively participated by more than 1,000 residents of Coron, comprised of multi-sectoral members, farmers, fishermen, elders, the youth, Tagbanwas, church leaders, teachers, students, foreigners, and even non-Coronians, as well as children, walked to the illegally reclaimed site in a historic peaceful rally. Previously scared and apathetic, the people of Coron came in full force and are now speaking out against the few powerful, greedy, and corrupt national and local government officials and businesses who have illegally reclaimed several hectares of seafront and mangrove areas and are now taking action to protect and preserve their environment.
So yung naging impact po sa amin ang seafront is nakatulong kami sa bayan ng Coron sa pag-rehabilitation po nito na tumahon ulit po sa mga nangyayari sa paligid natin.
Alam nyo, yung dulot po ng tambak na to, yung reclamation na po sa amin bilang mga isda ay napakalaking kawalan po sa amin. Ilang hektarya po na yung ating mga mangroves ay nawala, yung ating mga corals, higit yung ating mga lusay, yung ating mga baryaw na pinitirhan ng ating mga isda at yamang dagat dito sa bayan ng Coron.
This unprecedented initiative has empowered the community to continue fighting for Coron and unite as one in preserving its beauty for the next generations to come. They feel overwhelming pride that they have been instrumental in bringing the critical environmental issues of Coron to the attention of the President and at the forefront of national concern. Now, more and more Coronians are signing up for the petition to demand the stoppage of the reclamation, forfeit the illegally reclaimed lands in favor of the state, redesign it for purely ecotourism purposes as a park and marine sanctuary, and hold those responsible for the massive environmental destruction accountable and punished to the fullest extent of the law. This is truly people power in action. As part of the rehabilitation process, Sagip Coron Palawan has also engaged a reputable and credible team of marine scientists to conduct an independent marine ecosystem study, assess the adverse impacts of the illegal reclamation in Coron, and to come up with a roadmap for its short-term and long-term rehabilitation. This will address the grave economic loss for the fisherfolks, residents, and Tagbanwas who heavily depend on the now dead and buried mangroves, seagrass, and coral reefs as spawning grounds for fish and other marine species for their food and livelihood for generations. Of course, an executive order creating a Coron Interagency Task Force to be signed by the President and providing for its powers and functions to rehabilitate the environmental destruction of Coron Island from illegal reclamation and quarrying and hold accountable all parties responsible is the ultimate goal. The Coron Interagency Task Force will be mandated to put together a master plan to protect and preserve Coron's pristine environment and transform the worst catastrophic environmental devastation in Coron into a perfect opportunity to showcase the restored or even more enhanced natural beauty of Coron as our country's priceless asset and national pride. In turn, this will help save Palawan as the Philippines' last ecological frontier. Sagip Coron Palawan will soon establish a multi-sectoral, nationwide, and all-volunteer movement as a watchdog to prevent and stop all illegal reclamations. Coron is just the beginning of the people's advocacy to protect and preserve the rich biodiversity of the country's marine life and terrestrial landscape, and a rare opportunity to collaborate with the entire government in a whole-of-nation approach. It is the people's hope that in rehabilitating Coron, it will become the model and template for the protection and preservation of the environment in the country as a whole and leave it as a lasting legacy for future generations.